of early kills.
All right, EMEA week one, finals one, week one open one, whatever it's called. The finals is Smoke Break versus Team Risk, and we see the Fenrir priority from Smoke Break, double backline, which is pretty good here. Amir Chark also fine. Getting Barkus Bologna is interesting. I'm not gonna lie. And then they lock a pretty bad back line compared to these two, you know. I think this top three by Team Risk is, without a doubt, what they wanted, or what anyone would want, I feel. And then top two here is fine, and then this is just kind of whatever. Neath is a great god, don't get me wrong, but it's still a fine draft. Zeus is the only meh god. And then here, these two are fine gods as well, especially if it's Blown to Jungle, it's not too bad. I just think to just, you know, pull ahead, off of Hades is a bit mid. But then again, I haven't really seen many tank Hades. So we'll go back. So Johnny starting speed side of the jungle. Lazbra starting solo side. Red side. Two Sunders versus three. Smoke Break have solo support, you know, maybe with... It's weird that Johnny has an Aegis. That's interesting. That's very interesting. I don't know the tech here. Little gamble here. Who gets it? Benko gets it. That's Deathwalker, if you weren't sure.
And they're in the grand finals, right? So,
so Deathwalker was the one invading there. A super, super vertical jungle by Lazbra. Doing red backs before resetting to his own side of the jungle. That's very good. Very, very, very strong. Now that there's nothing that Johnny's able to farm on the right side of the jungle. I really like that. But we're seeing Silence do the exact same thing to Lazbra. They need to go back to that red buff side of the jungle. Very crazy that Johnny's able to get that mid camp. Not gonna lie. If the pressure truly does mount up that heavily. Out pressured, but oh god, early Aegis too. This is a miserable start for this Fenrir, I'm not gonna lie. But we see Doylene kind of goes back to normal now, with Silence getting both buffs. There should be a dead Barkus, to be honest. Yep, he's gone. Nothing he can do here. Well done. Pretty clean. Pretty crazy for Genetics to flop in into an EMEA. Like, he can't ever get his three off. Aegis used, very nice.
Aegis on the flip side.
Maybe not as nice if he's gonna back anyway. Not like it has too much of an impact, but he didn't have to Aegis if he just planned to back and fly in.
Too shabby for Silence on the EMEA.
Yeah, there's gonna be a couple little niche interactions. That
I am interested in the Transcendence rush by Angry, not an Int rush by Angry. That might seem confusing. He does scale. I feel like, if unless I'm mistaken, his build normally looks like this with the Book of Thoth rush, same that BMT is doing here. Or Theeks, shouldn't dead name him. On someone, there is a stun involved. I also don't see how Variety can play this lane as the Hades. But here comes the gank. Oh, that was interesting. He's dead. No, he's not. He is. That's how you play the Hades lane, I guess. You just get ganked. Dude, this is so aggressive. You know, it feels like we're watching NA. But Smoke Break is still 200 gold up. Unsure what from. I feel like Team Risk should be up just from the jungle start, but Silence, maybe the Silence trade on the left side was actually that good. Okay. Roxy? Why would you use your hammer there? That's kind of crazy, but... Dead Barkus coming. No.
Team Risk, not a team that you're just gonna
E-Chrome, no mana.
Roll over as far as farm goes. You gotta play well, not only in lane.
Whoa,
but in your macro
crazy wall.
As well.
There's no way that was intentional.
Nice little wall back there from Silenced.
Yeah, this vertical jungling's nuts.
Looking for a little invade of his own. One thing I was gonna ask Trelly.
I really like it. How, like, the entire map is able to be farmed by both members.
There might be a scrap that Johnny can
Chrome should fall
behind here if he wants to help out his team, but there might not be any reason. Genetics has jumped in and E-Chrome just melted through in the meantime.
Interesting to die for a back camp when you're actually trading the jungle anyway. So like it's not even like they're getting a good invade off because Johnny's still farming.
Johnny's gonna continue to farm.
Johnny got two speed buffs. I didn't see if Hades and Bologna took this red side jungle. I would assume so. And then you see Deathwalker trying to get the blue. He gets the blue, but there's no way he gets out, right? He does. He does get out. And he's doing a transcendence rush too. I think he's fine. Man, but Laspa really prioritizing this Hades lane, which is something I kind of commented on a little bit earlier, that Hades should be punished pretty hard in lane, but pretty hard to punish it if you camp it. Make sure it stays safe.
Long cooldown, and with 30 seconds, E-Chrome's gonna have to watch his positioning. Because just imagine a Zeus and Smite 1 with very limited mobility and no beads or Aegis.
A bit forced by Johnny to come over here, but there's nothing else to do.
E-Chrome's gonna be at for the next 20 seconds. Probably should be
no ult here for Benko.
Johnny 1 level down to Lazbra's.
Oh, they're gonna keep going.
Has a chance for a kill here, however. Ragnarok.
Yeah, alright, nice. That's the Neetha value. Quite large. I don't think Lazbra kills them here. Don't fight though, Johnny. You're fine. Interesting that he wanted to turn that.
Eagles rallied in. Yeah, good luck saying that.
Rally here.
A chance to chase.
Not level 6 still by Johnny. Kind of rough. Lazbra getting a full wave. Probably a level and a half up.
Just the one kill. Johnny now with the assist.
Interesting.
Hadn't done much over in that that early first blood.
It is just a lot of these solo waves being split by Laz. Johnny's still on the map at like one quarter. Blow that up. He gets it. Lazbra cannot kill that. I don't know what he's chasing for. Johnny has speed buff, so nothing can happen. Silence gets. Ooh, nice stun into Hecate. Four people mid. Oh my god, Angry's done work there, to be honest. Angry kind of starred on him.
And Genetics has added another one. Man, it's a stumble from
dude, I just think that Hecate ult is so valuable.
Because
it helps your dive, like it helps the Barkus dive the tower, and makes it a very safe fight. But also, if you get dove, you can ult away and teleport. And then like make the separation even further between the enemy front line and their back line. Positionally, just super ult. And I hope they don't change the range ever in any iteration. I think the range is very good. Yeah. What was I talking about? Oh, Hecate ult being perfect range. I think it's very rare that an ult comes out and it's a really nice balanced range, in my opinion, right? But I think it's hit the nail on the head there. Like, channel time's fine, the amount of effective range is fine. I think she's just got a really good kit. Now, Benko, where is the build? Transcendence is finished. E-Chrome getting dashed on by Streak. It's just not fair. That character's just so disgusting. Genetics ult angry. What is it? Eagles rally catches. Ooh. Oh, you have killed Angry. Unlucky.
God,
who put the mushroom down? I'm guessing Genetics.
That's a hand delivery from Johnny, a kill to Lazbra. You're gonna trade
the fact is, like, even though those plays feel bad for, like, let's say Angry, and he's probably going to be angry about it, it's a shutdown for sure on Lazbra. It's definitely worth it.
He's not laughing. I bet you during the whole
he's angry.
You say, no! Just get him away! I basically hand deliver the kill.
Ekrom's surely dead here.
It was a 3-0 shutdown, so it ends up...
Genetics mushroom rush. He's able to just dive this for free. E-Chrome moves up to clear the wave.
Oh, E-Chrome's a big trouble.
Maybe... Oh, he's dead. He's just dead. But that was actually like the best pathing he could have taken. Weird teleport. What is this TP?
Peak smoke break, Trelly. Give up some early kills. Get out skirmish.
What is that TP? Are they playing for this tower definitely?
The farm difference has just so heavily been in smoke break's favor.
Are they trying to kill the Zeus behind tower?
Deaths have not mattered. totally the opposite story now.
Little lane swap's cool, I guess. Like, they're swapping the roles of jungler slash... Smoke break. Oh, they are. No.
Game one far from over in this best of three.
No, dude.
But E-Chrome's left may be over once more. Oh, no. Yeah, lightning storm.
Oh, gosh.
Get drunk, whatever. Variety. Variety.
That's... That is... Honestly, that's what you get for playing,
For E-Chrome. Two deaths in the last minute.
Zeus ADC, I'm not gonna lie.
They're gonna be able to chase down more, both Variety and Genetics.
This has to be overstaying by Genetics and Variety. I think it's mega troll by him. But there's no like real punish factor unless Johnny has ult. Johnny does have ult. But oh my god, it's disgusting. They've just split them up way too much. They keep picking them off one by one. Still only a 3k lead at 10. So it's actually, well, 3k at 10, that's kind of crazy. Never mind, I was going to say it's not that bad, but at 10 minutes, it's not the best. Especially when you're playing Zeus ADC 0-3, not much you can do. No real value you bring either. Johnny looks like he's going into Tekakagi, second item, Lazbro going the tanky route. Pharaoh's Curse? They don't even have a steroid on their team. I don't like that. I don't know why he's built Pharaoh's Curse. You don't know what Pharaoh's Curse does? It's like an attack speed slow around you. Unless it's a strength reduction also, I could see that being part of an argument. But two level lead Lazbro has on Johnny. Oh my god. He gets him. And now all they have to do is get out.
Alright, we can exhale. That may have been... The final nail.
Man, this smoke break team does not like disengaging. Like, does not like just leaving.
Unlucky, because you're going to trade out your life for it. Benko
very rough.
Uses everything to get away and
honestly, this is the way messier than I thought it would be.
So a nice moment
there. Just constant fighting. Not over much, either. Like,
falls down to 0-2.
Team Risk, I don't see... Outside of Zeus camping... I don't see the reason as to why they're doing all this crazy shit.
It's just been really difficult to deal with. Lazbro has made some good plays on the Bologna as well.
You would think, honestly, with... So, one of the biggest difference with Smite 1, Smite 2 is camps are 2 minutes, like red buff, speed buff, purple, blue. They're 2 minutes in Smite 1. And now they're 3 minutes. So, you'd think that the pace would actually slow down, but... Second Gold Fury for Team Risk, not even contested. So much pressure, like just every mid tower's gone, duel lane tower's gone. They're not catching any waves, it's just a free Gold Fury. And if they showed up to defend, they're losing, you know.
They are not making any, I don't want to say risky plays.
Oh no, this poor Zeus.
They aren't making any mistakes here. And they are just going.
He's just dead.
E-Chrome does have blink back.
Oh, maybe there's a trade potential here. Good wall. Streak, you need to hit the Zeus, brother. Nice mushroom. Zeus, you should kill them both here, Streak. Oh, he was so unsure. I think Streak played that really bad, I'm not gonna lie. Lazbro still gets the kill, but... Well, Streak gets it, but... What was he so worried about?
Trade him out one for one, genetic silence, both supports down.
He was like max tethering his range, afraid to walk in, afraid to get into range of the Zeus that's like three levels down on him, or was.
That ends up going down. And needed the rotation from Lazbro to make their way.
They're very scared. From Genetics, I'm a bit peeved. I'm not going to lie. Speaking of Genetics, he gets the beads active. And across the way, Silenced also has the beads active. Purification Cleanse, I think it's called. I don't know what it's called. But we're going to call it beads every time.
Made up one of the best, and I mentioned it in Picks and Bans, one of the best map state teams of all time in the Camelot Kings.
Oh, Streak, solid? No. Oh my god, no.
Over on left is going to go towards Streak up at E-Chrome.
Angry no ult. Would have been a fine play if there was an angry ult coming, like an Aether ult coming.
I'm maybe not surprised that the map is being played this well by this Team Risk.
Wasn't there. Tekagagi done for Johnny. Whereas Lazbro, Berserkers, super tanky Lazbro build.
And all the history we've seen from Smite 1.
Absolutely, and I do
think it's fine. Spirit Robe's banned, by the way, so you won't be able to see Spirit Robe in any of these games. Benko with Prophetic Second? I think that's kind of crazy.
Take a look at Team Risk.
Genetics has Amity,
not gonna lie,
charm, which is gonna be big regen. That's the mushroom that you drop.
Not that it's a bad game, but I think you just get that first. Sure, it's such a long needs, item
you don't
to stack.
Really need it if your support picks up this pure, this team wide purification.
It's 30 instances of damage on a 10-second cooldown.
Okay. Maybe Johnny gets active.
Yeah, Johnny, you can't 1v1 this Bologna. You gotta look for the CC. Like, take zero damage. There's a mushroom comes out. Genetics gets picked up. Yeah, you can't bring him in. You have to run away. This is the... Oh, what the...
Just on the back foot.
What was that?
That'll be a kill, an easy one onto silence, and it's a fight over on the fire giant side.
Oh, and Johnny's dead too. Oh, he picks up the shield.
Johnny's got a teammate up and over the wall.
Alright, that's a fire giant for sure.
Decent bit of damage.
Nothing that
yeah, I mean, look,
blue team can do. ADC so far behind.
So you're essentially in a 5v3. Should
I don't have any follow up on
and some sustain. Thank you,
Johnny's ult. And honestly, building everyone tank is kind of hard to kill anybody with a Fenrir ult or even solo. Nice. Benko's definitely dead here, but. Damn, I thought this would be. Maybe this is just a game one moment, like feeling it out. Surely the set doesn't go this poorly.
I'm taking the fire giant and the kill over tier 1 every day of the week, Dave. Not to mention the
oh my god, he still just gets farmed by last two. Like, look at it.
Second now. That one is going
crazy.
To deal with, unfortunately, as Johnny is forced to run away as well.
Two item. Fenrir, this is not what I'm used to seeing. Looks like it's going to be a void shield. Ooh, I don't know what builds out of those two items. I'm not going to lie. Silence is building the mushroom. I know that one. Then that Thebes item. I know that is the Thebes item. The blue cloak down the bottom that you can see with Johnny. And just FizzD. Oh, no. That's a stone of binding. Because that shield isn't FizzD, is it? It's magical and physical protection. Once again, it's a free free game for Risk, to be honest. They just get every tier 2 tower reset into the second fire, and then they can end off second fire. Pretty easy end game phase for Team Risk. I should probably just start talking about them rather than the blue team, because all blue team can do is capitalize on mistakes. They can't actually play the game proactively, which is really rough with a Neith Fenrir comp. Well, this might be the mistake I was talking about. He's trying to go over a wall that he can't. Alright, that's one, and then you have to stop. You have to just start getting one and dones across the map.
This game has just not gone well for Ekrom up to this point. How much does it matter, though? Ever the map state players is Team Risk. Send their way over to the tier 2 tower. Over on the left side of the mini-map.
Dream scenario is they don't get mid tier 2. If you are...
Smoke Break has a chance to collapse in.
Team, what? Smoke Break, not Team Risk. Ah, Silence is dead in every scenario. No, he's not. Yeah, he is. Oh my god, Angry's trolling. That's the game? Streak is just putting on a clinic, let's be honest.
Just
reset here, you don't even stay. They might try for the end. I don't think it's a good call to go for the end. This is a very genetics call. Yeah. I don't know what he's thinking. Nah, you just back and you get a free win. Interesting to go for the crazy emotional play. Even this is incorrect, I think, staying for this tier 2 tower. Please reset soon, everybody.
Not for nothing, Trelly. That Titan is now down to half HP. Won't sustain up while those Phoenixes are down, and so... I mean, if you're talking about really trying to force the issue here, Team Risk can group up and only have half a Titan to deal with.
Variety gets Gem of Focus? Like, fourth item? That's crazy to me.
They like and cool common
Genetics is getting the helm of Radiance, I think. The yellow helmet, not the invisible helmet. Streak, super strong build. Not like a ice skating build, but just pure damage. E-Chrome's going like a pseudo ice skating build with the Musashi's dual swords. Wants to be moving fast. I can understand that in Zeus because you're immobile. But yeah, Streak is just pure damage. Do not mind it. Benko got the double move speed too. Benko, very, very squishy. Not what you want into a Fed ADC. There's no Leviathan's Hide, there's no Spectral, there's no Pharaoh's Curse. Oh, I reckon it stacks. If they're both building that, that has to stack. Because Mushroom stacks, right? You can just pop both. If you pop double Pharaoh's Curse, you don't expect it has to be the reason. All variety dead? Not a good trade.
No, not yet.
If that Hades died, it's a good play. Oh my god, he's still alive. That was just a mushroom.
And all the rest of the healing that Variety's got.
Alright, GG. End the game.
The floor with smoke break.
What was that flop?
Final fight
end the game.
Number one. Benko's gonna scurry away. And he'll just have to head back.
I like this by Genetics. You know, he's staggering the back from Deathwalker.
Timer's long enough. Maybe take this Phoenix.
The Neith was unable to scale. The Zeus did absolutely nothing, which isn't really shocking. The build from Deathwalker is a bit troll in my opinion. Like, that's like a jungle build with a prophetic in it. Silence, fine build. Johnny also goes shifters, that's what it is. But triple mushroom too strong. And double Pharaoh's Curse. Theek's also getting a run of Tahuti pretty early. As you can see, so Streak, that game was just Streak doing whatever he wanted. I'm not gonna lie, there was no pressure on him. I think Fenrir is decent into it also, but the game kind of went really bad really early, and then with how easy everything is to kill on the map, it's really hard to come back from a deficit, especially with a pick comp like Neith Fenrir, and then I'm sure like it was a pick comp with the classic Fenrir Zeus tech, but it just didn't really take off. There was no way for them to play proactive with how down bad they were. Alright, game two. Hecate first pick into Odin Barkus, very strong. Amir Susan in retaliation, also very strong. I think these are great drafts by both teams. Jingwei Ban is... it's funny that they absolutely dominate on it and then they get rid of it, which I can understand. And then Fenrir, I also think, is warranting a ban here. No real jungler on the side of Smokebreak, by the looks of it,
number two, and avoid a,
is the only downside, where everything here is pretty traditional, very traditional Smite, when you look at this. Bellona slash Susan has some flex potential, like, is Bellona going jungle, or is Susan going jungle, the other going solo? But into Odin, I think you can play Bellona solo, and into Odin, I wouldn't really want to play Susan solo unless you know the matchup. And I don't know how many games these solo laners have in that Odin Susano matchup, because I think it is favorable for Susan if you're good at it. But anyway, Variety is on the Bellona, Lazbar on the Susan, Benko on the Odin, Johnny on the Chalk. Another Neath mid.
It's going to be Johnny on the Chalk. He's going to put the Chalk in the jungle.
Johnny on the Chalk, you know, jungle. Maybe he heard what I said last game. This is the one matchup where I think he can actually be aggressive early as Bellona, funnily enough.
Really wreck a game.
Oh, and Hades too, level there. One, if you find him in the jungle. Three Sunders versus two. Johnny, Link on Chalk makes sense, especially for these late game team fights. Lazbar, no Blink, Lazbar, no Beads. Loves his Sunder. And I don't mind it, because what it does is it negates any annoying invades. Like if Silence chose to show up and try to annoy the jungler, he can just ignore it. What's Variety doing? Pulling the wave? Does that do anything here?
In the past, But I
doesn't seem to do anything here.
Towards the end of season 10.
Okay, so Chalk.
In a really good game, honestly, in game number one.
Unable to do anything.
Susano gives him the opportunity. I was talking about.
All right, we got to go back and dissect this. So blue team is double invading. And Johnny's unable to get anything on this side of the map. And Barkus is invading this side with Silent. Blue team is at... They are on every buff, essentially. Johnny is cooked already at the start of the game. Like, yeah, Benko does get blue.
Take this game over and get things started for Team Risk here in game two.
I'm just looking at the starts here. Interesting.
No way, Lasbro got it. Oh, okay, he didn't. Thank God. Red buff's going to do a bit of work there. That gave Variety free lane pressure.
Take away the red buff.
Lasbro does end up actually.
Genetics is also invading farm all the while Silence is invading farm.
Sorry, I'm going back again. So Chalk does backs to mid because he knows that Amir is going to take his backs. So there's no point going to look. So you get mid pressure to make sure you guarantee this mid camp, the yellow camp.
But if everyone's invading, aren't we all?
And now Johnny's fine.
Right, that's my camp on the other side.
And Angry's a bit behind. And by the time Lasbro finishes these two camps, which he's not doing, he's going to mid.
Yeah, I guess those camps matter, so,
that's interesting. I really want to see mid. I don't really care about this duo fight because
besides that, it just seems like a ton. Invading
all and solo doesn't matter either. This does matter. I want to see who hits three here. And Angry does hit three first. Two side camps plus. Okay, that's not too bad then. Dude, just running mid and guaranteeing the mid camp plus the oracles is actually the play. And streak gone. Not gone.
Still left running underneath his tower, Benkova.
What is genetics doing?
No, there's a stun on the flip side from.
Hey, how does he not die here? We're going back again. This game's way more interesting than last game.
A survivability relic.
Okay, they go in. Streak gets stunned. Oh, he doesn't get stunned. He gets flopped. The shell value.
Still left running underneath his tower, Benkova.
Genetics.
One more auto. No, there's a stun on the flip side.
No Sunder for genetics. If he had Sunder, that was a dead Deathwalker. Any plates to get here? No. Ooh, clean up by Lasbro. Red team are river staying. Nice wall.
The biggest fan of the level 2 gank, maybe of all time.
Oh, good. Look at this teleport, too. By Variety. If he had ult, it would have been way better.
Silence had to get away.
Massive shit fight, but still fun to watch. That one was good. I liked it. He was able to teleport because Benko backed, so he had free time to teleport. Right? That's why the Variety TP was fine. We're seeing a dev gloves into full tank, I think, from Variety on the Bologna. I think that's fine. Science Thieves is fine.
Makes his way over as
one
well.
Thing I would like to see.
There's a hot and cold for me.
Oh, hang on.
The addition of the teleporter.
Not that. Yes, it's he just kind of jumped in and did nothing. I was going to say, I'd like to see Streak up get a chins this game. But I don't think he will.
What in the world is that burst from genetics and Streak? Oh, it's devastating for Team Risk. You play that.
All right, Gold Fury coming up, Soul backing. But a lot of people on the right side of the map, on the solo side of the map. Variety has to call. Surely Lasbro gets out of there.
Streak's got the one level lead. Gonna build up even a little bit more, and still a chase down happening over on the duo side.
Honey wins this sustain wall. Weird blink. Nice. Oh, mechanics. All right, he does die. He does die. But on the other side of the map, genetics picks. Ooh, Silence is alive. Oh my god, it doesn't stop. The Bologna's fighting in mid, too. Crazy. Does Angry get a full clear into gold camp or no? I see now. I was looking at EU players' scrims and stuff, and they were all like, had so much player damage in 28 minutes or something. And I see why they do now. They're just fighting constantly for the first 10 minutes of the game.
I mean, the Cernunnos build has been pretty consistently just full intelligence. Streak does not seem to be going that route.
Yeah, you can't pick that up, brother. Angry, you can't pick it up. Oh, nice. Going for a little bait. Good combo. Perfect combo. How does he have shell up again? I guess it is 2 minutes. Is it a 2 minute cooldown? It is 2 minutes, 10 seconds.
From Benko over to solo lane.
Good by Streak to just use it. Right?
Streak was holding that one, no problem. Does not have to
work. Now what you could do is have teleport advantage for blue team. But he doesn't teleport back. Benko's still just sitting here doing nothing. Bologna, dude, Bologna getting a proxy into a teleport here is huge.
Teleported back.
Theeks, is it Theeks holding the map?
And Variety trades out, but can Variety get something done now, though? Good. I mean, Variety's still over here. Variety about to get his ultimate back. Eagles rally not quite there. That could be used for follow-up.
Oh, this is bad. Red team. Absolutely farm this fight.
Genetics roots himself in place and just gets burned.
Frame just needs to walk. Oh, that's so heartbreaking. You hit the flop, you have the slow, and then blink. Oh my god, it's tragic. X. Chrome definitely could have got out there. But it's fine, it's fine. The peel was insane by Johnny and silenced. Theeks gets engaged on. Nice. Interesting. No gold falling yet? Now gold will fall. Surely blue team just rips it. Angry charging alt in mid. Nothing's happening. Genetics is not going to rip it. Because he has the gargoyle, he doesn't have the mushroom.
Puts out a giant silence radius in front of you. I have never seen it used.
Oh, this jet's still flying. Games, that's crazy. I'm curious. I don't know if Michael picked that up, though. So I like the screeching gargoyle for two reasons. We'll see. Goes bang. Gets the, and there it is. Oh, he's walled off his jungle. Well done, Genetics. It does really well into the Sunder meta because you can't use actives during the time you're silenced. But it's also good into Barkus. He can't burp on you, right? You're able to just start looking for freezes if you really want them, but like jump in, freeze a backliner, and then you can silence as a secondary peel.
Was there and potentially still there for a chase. Looks like Team Risk realizing they don't know the exact numbers of smoke break. Don't want to stick around.
I can't believe Chrome's looking for this. They're just going jungle timers, maybe.
Once again from Team Risk, get the
streak. Oh, he jumped in.
Yeah, you got exact numbers here. Lazbra started things off with the first blood. Now get shoved aside. Oh, dashes right into the.
Oh, dude, people like Lazbra do my head in. Like Chrome literally phantom shells him, and he runs around like he's lost. What are you doing? Like leave with your ADC. Like run back. Run towards the damage source. Wall. Oh, wrong side. That's fine. But once again, like the farming is so minimal. Even game, let's be honest, it's not really that good. Mid laner taking speed, I think it's fine because there's just so much stuff to do on the map. One thing that really needs to change is this UI, like these back camps, red. I'm sure they're all up, but they just look like they're a quarter of the way until they spawn. Ecrom to separate down. I think that was shell as well, but red side. Broken relics.
Until about 15 minutes, that's when the fire giant could be instant done. We've seen it done.
Yeah, Lazbra has red. Level 8 for Lazbra. Level 9 for Johnny. Takagi done. Angry has trans. Ecrom has devs. Benko void shield rush. Right now, not a fan of that one. I'm not a fan of that one. And it looks like Variety's pretty close to his berserkers. Both components done. He just needs to finish it.
Not the meta build. But definitely still viable.
Lazbra, he gets stunned by silence.
Yeah, return that poke, big time.
Good poke, good poke. The jet stream has the damage.
Is he dead? Yes, he is.
There's just too much follow up.
Kinetic's dead in return. Damn, Johnny did some damage. That's crazy.
Away, but this is something, Charlie, that's happened time and time and time again. Almost no clean one and out kills for Team Risk this game. Smoke.
I agree with Dolson. There's never a clean one and out.
To trade out. This time it's supports taking a tumble.
Johnny.
Stay tied up at 4-4. And something we've not.
I hope he wants to back after he gets that gold camp, because the amount of time it takes to grab that's kind of crazy.
Fans of this roster will be happy with. They've got a
gold. Also, next patch, Cern gets mega buffed, which is our Tuesday for us. All right, no, Wednesday for us, or Tuesday night, 9 p.m., 10 p.m. Mid camp, gonna be fought over? No. What, Lass? What are you doing, brother? Oh, Johnny, what are you doing, brother?
Lasbra has not been cleaned up.
Everyone out on 1 HP.
Go back in, probably smart, a stiff breeze.
Interesting.
We'll finish off the kill onto Lasbra.
Both mid laners were ultless that fight. And I think both junglers die if both mid laners had ult. Funnily enough.
Balancing on that knife's edge to stay alive.
Thix needs to back. He's been on... Oh, he has just backed and he just got GM. I was about to say, he's been on that cooldown ring for such a long time.
Look at Johnny. Just farming a little bit better at the moment.
And I can't believe Genetics hasn't been punished.
Susano still does crazy damage, but when you're
like the angry slash... I should just use god names. The Neath Charcoalt onto that Genetics, onto that Amir. He has no Fizz D in his build until just now. So 10 minutes, no physical defense apart from base. Very killable guy. He did go magical defense because of the double magical lane, like E-Chrome plus Barkus, or like Soul plus Barkus, obviously. What is he doing here?
I wouldn't be surprised if we saw on the left side of the map. E-Chrome.
Dying.
Some trouble here. Unfortunate.
We'll take the easy way out and not give a kill over to the opposing team. Unless I've missed something.
I guess. Don't know how come he thought he had to die there. And that wasn't English what I just said.
Give it to the tower instead, but...
Silenced has to die here.
Could be impactful. Because Team Risk, kill or not, now have an advantage on
the
map.
Yep. Variety. Already doing a lot of work with just this first item devs. But then again, Silence kind of running it down. Unsure if they have Sunder. Yeah, they do.
Silence being down. Fury pulled. A bit of damage taken away. Genetics. Unable to get the Silence.
Variety falls. Finally punished for no defense. This Odin's so annoying, so cringe, some might say. Big cage to save. Oh my god, everyone's just 1 HP. Lass is 1, Odin is 1. BMT, for some reason, has gone to Narnia to fight instead of sitting with Streak up. Close fight.
Had an opportunity
I don't know what Feex was doing there.
Was low, he
played way too odd. Played like a right flank angle. To see if anyone probably ran back towards mid, I think, was the play. But they all ran towards Duo.
Still,
it's one of those plays where you look like a genius if they do walk to the right up this way. But if they don't, it's just Goffins.
I'm not sure exactly how much Feex was able to do to help Lasbro there. I did see the shield come down. But again, it's only physical damage. So if there was any physical damage,
man, Variety back in mid.
Juking, but I think Deke definitely helped out in the survivability there.
He's Variety just gonna take half of his HP.
Here comes the ultimate, pulls the beads away from Silence.
Silence just uses his actives. They better pull gold off this. They've got pressure in mid. They've got pressure in duo.
Item, by the way. He didn't start beads, yes.
They don't. The jungler and the solo. They reset back to solo whilst Odin teleports back to duo lane. This is crazy. Odin should get a good cage here. But this is the guy with Phantom Shell. Just cage the... Oh. Well done by Genetics.
Love the little knockbacks from the Emir wall. We've been seeing that a few times here in the first handful of games we've seen from...
This mid camp not up. Susan just walks by, grabs the mid wave.
The storyline around Emir and...
Benko wants to force this?
It was like, either you're going to carry this game or you're going to go... Oh,
Susan,
10, right? Like Ymir just felt like the ultimate.
Finally picking up this camp. Jeez, this camp's been there for a while. Johnny gets Variety. Variety's dead. Come on.
A bit more success here in Smite.
No Neath ult needed. Beautiful. They still have. Oh no, they already Neath ulted. Never mind. Let's see this Queen Naga go down? No, they're going straight to gold. Genetics is low, therefore they can't contest.
Yeah, the ability
finally
to wall to just yeet yourself around the map and also move your two after casting it has made Ymir a night and day different character. As far as I'm concerned, it is so much easier. This
plain gold fury, there's no wave shoved in. Queen Naga is still on your side of the map, so it's safe. It's dream scenario. After that pick on resets here are fine in Duel Lane. Yeah, that's a great map state there for Smokebreak. They get a 3k lead, 3.5k lead. And unfortunately, the Naga's now on the move. Oh, hey, fine trade.
Exactly where he's heading. He's not going back.
Binko, full cooldown after the Void Shield. E-Chrome doing the Ice Skate build. Johnny with the Oni Hunter's garb. I like it. Yeah, Streak's doing a pen build. Streak is doing a pen build. Very good to see into Odin Shark.
It gave you, like, vision of a small area on the map. You know,
mid build for Theeks is the exact same as you'll always see. Streak, you are.
I don't know what I'm pitching here. Like a vision ward.
Oh, nice. Good trade here by Lass as well to get. Oh, what hit Ekrom? Oh, the Queen Naga was hitting Ekrom there. A lot of pressure here into the blue side jungle by the red team. Smokebreak want to be aggressive into Ymir. Here comes the wall. Just wait for that to go down, and now you actually can punish Ymir really easily, which they do. Susan in the back, it's a double kill. Oh no, Johnny comes in to save the day. That's massive. That's fine. Silence will be happy to die for that. But now you have to reset, lads. Oh, fighting this is dumb. Dude, these two carries are crazy. Oh man, they're going for a variety. Yeah, they're done. Backflip? Oh, nearly. Angry nearly pulled it off. Sol, you are playing with fire. Ekrom does not like backing here. Crazy play to not back.
Yeah, I'm really not sold on this Sunder pickup from last.
Oh my god, Neith is so disgusting.
This is all good. Lot of burst damage. You gotta watch out for those weaves coming through. But I'm just not sold on this Sunder pickup. I can't imagine you ever need three. You know, especially on Susano of all people, who just has no sort of immunity, not a lot of mobility. If
what is this? Let's be honest. He has Xe. They're playing off the Xe Frenzy Dagger, triple Sunder Power Spike. I still don't think it's that strong.
Now they hover close by. Both teams fully stocked
up. Alrighty.
5v5, few ultimates waiting to come back off of cooldown. At least for Team Risk.
Angry going for the Heartseeker next. Looks like Johnny getting.
Time to come back.
What does that build into outside of Tekkagagi and
really breaks this game open.
Tekkagagi and Jotuns? What else does that build into?
Throughout the tournament here today, we've seen them.
What is more cooldown rate?
Casually, when you just aren't looking, it's exactly what's happened in the last 5 minutes for me.
Mushroom coming from Silence. Nothing for Deathwalker. We can't see what he's building next. I'm so interested into what the Satchel turns into.
Man, rotation has been deadly. Lazbro's gonna walk faced first.
Man, angry with pressure is a different dude.
Luckily, can teleport away. Just
he just plays poke so well. He gets priority. Yeah. He uses it and then maybe seems to be pretty disciplined too with his like positioning.
Let's pull this FG and see if we can bait Team Risk in.
I think that is the call. Send Lazbro over to left lane. Let him get some
smoke break. Have the pressure here.
Try and steal away Fire Giant, but you know maybe you just send Genetics in to do
kill him. Guys, just kill the Genet. Kill the Ymir. Big ult here. Theeks gets a big ult there. Doesn't do too much. Bad cage. Okay, keep them out. The cage wasn't too bad. Let the back line deal with variety. Oh, Lazbro can go so big here. This is scary. But there's no Hecate ult. A lot of jumps on the side of the red team.
Sure that smoke break. No, Lazarus here. This could be
a Ekrom falling is whatever. He dies for this.
What else does he have right now?
He played time really well. Speed buff down. Decent trade. 2-for-1 trade. That's all that really was. Gold Fury comes up.
They've been able to do so.
The threat of a mage at Fire Giant is very annoying.
At this point, if you don't want Fire Giant to go down, you back up, you get the pick. Well played by Laz.
Especially something like the mechanic of Hecate's 2 out of FG will nearly be always be fully stacked if she leaves it up for a while. So you like, put the thing up in the sky, the orb. It'll stack up from 10 abilities being used pretty quickly, and then it's max damage. Something you don't really get too often in laning phase. Johnny looking for streak. But also, it's like an ambush on Johnny because Theeks can see Johnny. And look how fast Johnny is, just from Tekokagi. He doesn't have ult, does he? Oh, he does. Oh, Theeks gets both. Yeah, that's like, you think you're ganking, but you're getting ganked kind of angle. Unfortunate. Very, very unfortunate. What can red team do now, though? How can you split the map? You just run straight to, I'd run straight to Doylane Tower. There's no point contesting this FG. But it looks like they're gonna, which I really hate.
That was an ambush on top of an ambush.
I really don't like this positioning from red team.
And they're going to pull immediately. Pay attention to Variety already in the
back line. 15 seconds.
Uh-oh. Is there trouble brewing here? It still just slightly feels uneasy for Team Risk.
No, this is so free for Team Risk. This is how you win the game.
Maybe a couple more kills. FG, take it.
Like, red team are trolling.
And silence falls prey as well.
Oh, Chrome does strip one FG buff off, but like, didn't even have to. Like, Lazbra going in that deep is kind of crazy. I think that was an awful play by Smokebreak. It's a 19-minute FG, just let him have it. Oh my god, angry. Oh, it actually works.
Genetics nearly deleted, but the shielding, the freeze, the silence, all of it keeps them alive.
Oh my god, they're actually cooked. Wait, they've stripped everyone off. Dude, what is this bad discipline by the blue team, too? Crazy, crazy. They didn't back after FG, they tried to force too fast. Great play by Angry, let's be honest. Great play by Angry. Bad, bad discipline. Dude, Team Risk could have definitely, I don't know what they were thinking. They have so many towers that they could have sieged with that FG, but they chose not to. Like, they actually went to the open lane as well. Mid tier 1's up, Doi tier 1's up. They could have played it really slow, took both tier 1's straight to Gold Fury, reset again, play for a tier 2 tower, set up the next fire. Like, slowly choke it out, but they rushed it. Again, this is like 6 hours of Smite, isn't it? This is like, you have played for 8 hours. 4 best of 1's, now you're in a best of 3. You probably are a bit fatigued.
Now Team Risk really need to recenter themselves. You had a great moment. And maybe have tilted the scales back into your face.
Crusher
for a second, but
is the item that builds from the satchel. Direction. Didn't notice. So I'm guessing that this is what Angry's also getting. Crusher here. Crit the streak after doing a pretty good pen start build. Theek's getting a Reaver here.
Mid is the difference maker here. So there's still some gold on the map to be collected.
Double Mushroom. I wouldn't even be surprised if...
little traps have played such a role in this game.
Wait, what is Variety getting now?
I don't know if we're going to be completely silent.
Cooldown and attack speed.
And we got time. And considering the fact that we're in a little bit of a slow zone.
Not sure.
And more of these active items. I mean, genetics is already capped out. You can only have 3 active
items. I am unsure. What? Looks like Johnny...
Breaching Gargoyle, Amanita's Charm, and
is Johnny getting Reaper? Gargoyle again. Big what is Johnny getting here?
Spits out in a cone in front of you.
Typhon's Fang or Reaper?
Meditation gives you lots of sustain.
It has to be Reaper, right? Worse. Or is it a Dev Glove angle 5th?
We saw 3 of those, I believe, or maybe only 2, picked up last game. Great for chase down, great for peel.
Okay, E-Chrome should be pretty hard to pick. He has Musashi's Dual Sword and Fatalis, double move speed items, so he should be able to kite around. Only issue with, like, from my perspective is that I can't really kite around when a Susan just, like, kills you straight away.
I was about to troll for a second, so I appreciate you keeping me keeping me on track here, Trelly.
Berserker Shoguns is done, so what is Variety getting here?
I was going to ask you what you think the Screeching Gargoyle sounds like. I'm not sure we can
tell you exactly what I think.
Variety poking up Benko.
That's what it sounds like. I don't know if I peeked out there.
You know, like,
oh, that's a good one. Yeah, you get the little like rattle in the back there. That's pretty solid.
Forcing the alts, nothing more, nothing less. Ooh, that's a lot of economy down for red team. Smoke break, Odin ult down. Angry ult down too, but angry ults.
Beaks
goes for a pick, but Genetics just gets deleted. Wait a second. What happens to Genetics here? Is it just Spirit Arrow? He hits the backflip too, yeah. He gets a full combo off. How does Angry get a full combo off? Crazy. But there are some beads used. Lazarus doing his best Mollusk impression. Splitting the map when it's pretty crucial to defend something. You're also losing the split of the map to Johnny's Chark, who's shoving mid tower.
And Lasbro left running. All in the meantime, Johnny is rotated back to be with the rest of his team, but won't be an immediate fight.
They're going to chase to stop backs, like a soft chase kind of deal. Silence is lazy backing. Over the wall, he's fine.
Could be the final fight here in game number 2.
This is good. They want to keep everyone on the map for as long as possible. But the truth is, it doesn't really matter too much because they're not pulling fire on Rip.
Has just been stuck on farm duty. My man has not gotten an upgrade in a solid 6 minutes. Like,
all right, this Fire Giant. We saw last time it was Team Risk that won the Fire Giant pretty easily due to two picks, but that was off the back of a miracle ult. Right, Theek's got a miracle ult onto Johnny and Benko. And now Benko has beads. Thebes as well. Benko going to be unkillable.
Lazarus will do two of those things. He'll hit 20.
Love this setup.
He's not going to make it back to this Fire Giant before it gets taken down.
You're going to play for a wall. No, they're not.
Though the damage is a little bit delayed, so
stay on, stay on. Very clean. Genetics. Can't get in. Oh, he gets it.
Forward in goes Eagles Rally. Oh, Genetics gets it. Makes a play, and Lasbro has a kill onto Johnny as well.
I did see on Twitter that Angry said level 15 bug, so maybe Silence Sunder did like 100 damage instead of 1,000.
Not worried about, which is unfortunate.
But something else that was kind of cool, we'll go back and look at it. Angry and Benko. Ooh.
The rest of Team Risk.
So Genetics walks in, alright, three twos, he gets walled off, which is fine, but watch this. I think he tried to ult the Odin Spear, he walks up, really massive ults here by blue team. They get the Hecate ult and the Bologna ult on it. Genetics walks up, wait, Genetics gets silenced and steals FG. Genetics gets sundered. He just sunder secures it. We're gonna watch a sunder secure three times in a row. Dude. Massive beads there by Silenced as well. And then they can't kill Genetics.
Kill onto Johnny as well. Suddenly,
the back line of blue team are too healthy.
Right back up. Is there more damage to be had though?
It sucks to lose a game to a bug.
They'll make use of it. Not worried about the fight after the Fire Giant. If you can clean up the fight during the Fire Giant.
Streak played incredibly well this game, to be honest.
Two members of Smoke Break left running, and the plays have been made. A double pull.
Angry as well.
Has just fallen shy of another kill.
Yeah, Thieves want to try and chase down, can't find the kill, but you get...
Can they end here? Do they end off this FG? They do have an Odin, but there is an Emir on the other team. Both have siege hacks, kinda. At this point, you got some time on the respawn, 17 for Johnny. They have a second mushroom, too. Variety can use a mushroom in Titan Room. We'll just pop it now. Variety, please. No mushroom, you just hate your team. That's crazy.
Taken down ultimately. Team Risk, Trailer, they're going to follow your direction.
Dude, why would he
follow,
not?
What they've learned from this game already. FG, yeah, they stripped the jungle. Let's get out after the
Phoenix. There's the variety mushroom now. Crazy.
I swear to God, if they lose this fight, I'm gonna be so mad.
I mean, group up.
Oh,
they're going for it. That's not the target you want, though.
Whoa, big damage. Little flies over the wall. Oh, that's from Theeks.
Johnny's dead.
Forward,
he's not dead. He's just a genius. Silence gets a decent ult off, but unfortunately he falls. That fight's so good if he gets the kill on variety. It just sucks that he doesn't.
Team Risk this time, able to get the fight after.
Honestly, it's decent time sync. You know? Well done, Living by Johnny. Serrated. Oh, my brother. That sucks. I hate Serrated in Smite 2.
They still have to go through a tier
Gen X gets the Thebes last. I don't hate it. I do not hate it. Lazbro gets a Soul Reaver. This item needs to be nerfed. Soul Reaver needs to, obviously, it needs to be on scale with int on your items. Because you can just build it in a full strength and it still gets value. Soul Reaver needs to scale with int on items. Pretty simple.
They could have all been pulled back. That might have been game. If they actually did get pulled back in, but timed the CC immunity perfectly to make sure that did not happen. But now, smoke break. Do you
just running through left? Is that all they do?
Or do you wait under your Phoenix that is haunted by the Ancient Fury and will not help you in this engagement? Let's find out. I mean, tier one dropped immediately.
You are able to play in the Titan room this game. Theeks does exist.
Well, why would they, right? Smoke break. This is how they got back into game two here. Couple of times
that did no damage.
You're out swinging. I said it during picks and bans. You don't play not to lose. You got to draw your line somewhere. You can't just say, all right, we'll give up the tier two. All right, we'll give up the Phoenix. Eventually, you got to fight.
Yeah, that's right, Dolson. But you want to fight in the Titan room. That shit's broken.
Really worried about the Phantom Shell and the Aegis for Team Risk. Both of those still hanging out. In goes one. Variety rooted in place.
That item really negates the pressure
Phoenix is not taking
from Hekate.
Over on left. Remember, there's gonna be
I think you need a drafter with a better support so or jungler like a Beads Burner.
Is gonna have to deal with those.
Oh my god.
What just happened to the back line of smoke?
What did just happen?
They've got to get back to their fountain, and I think that just concedes this left side Phoenix.
Oh, good wall by Genetics. Unlucky. They walk out. Team Risk. If they reset and go right, the game's still winnable for Red Team.
Yeah, that is the Hekate 2-1 you just watched. And the ultimate came through. Beautiful purification.
Man, I'm like...
That really didn't do too much, but the 2-1...
Oh, Benko.
The bait, the trap, it's laid.
No, Silence is dead.
Are able to find
what was that flop?
Well.
All right, that was
could
crazy.
Be a winning moment here for Team Risk on day one of our Smite 2 Founder Series. Three members of
any mushrooms? Team. Yep, they're Variety right has back. A mushroom. Genetics has his up to. That's the game,
feel
folks.
Good about their chances. They'll step forward.
Walk in, chuck the mushroom
time.
Down, Genetics. Well done.
Some damage towards the
Titan. Don't wall the Titan, Genetics. It doesn't work.
Gotta clean up some of these carries, but Streak is just all on his own, all on the left.
Yep.
Working
that's
down the
game.
Team Risk, unreal comeback in game two.
That firefight could have gone either way. I wasn't really too convinced that either team were winning or losing. You know what I mean? Until FG, and then it is rough that FG's so busted. Very, very strong. Silence did shit it up, but then, like, that's just the role of support at the moment. Not much you can do. We'll go to the post-game screen. Yep.
What a squad. They find a
pause. See, Genetics went like a zero health build until here, until this item. But then again, healing from mushrooms pretty big. That heroism gives you a lot too. Level 20, not too bad. Like nearly level 20 on the side of Genetics. Angry played like lights out. Played really, really well. It was just two plays that made this really bad for the red team. One thing that I really enjoyed, the dynamic starts of blue team really prioritizing invading. So every buff was pressured at the start of the game. What are we at? I thought this was sick. But then I also like the answer from Johnny, right?
I just hit down there for
Lasbro the opportunity.
If we look at the map, blue team have someone on purple or speed, red and blue. Like, they're literally invading everything.
But I think fine.
And this should be coffins for Johnny. You know what I mean? It should be over.
In a really good
they get blue, they get red. Johnny has to do double back camps into mid. Barkus does strip away both camps here as well, which is also like kind of good for Johnny, bad for Lasbra. But it's also happening here, so it's neutralized.
Interesting up down there for he lost. Oh, he got it. Okay, I was gonna say there's no way he loses that. Benko took his one though.
That's also a massive reason this star went well, was Deathwalker's double invade on blue and red. Massive big brain by Deathwalker there.
Red buff. I was just taking a look at everyone's starts.
And then
look at your minimap, genetics is also
level two.
Farm all the while while
bang, level two into mid camps, into oracles. That's a beautiful start there for Johnny. Great by Deathwalker to double invade too. I'd say one of the better starts I've seen to cope with all the invade pressure. But then again, next week there shouldn't be as much invade pressure due to Sunder nerfs. Yeah. That was all right. That wasn't too bad. A lot more aggressive than I thought it would be. Game one draft diff was just too shit for the set. You know what I mean? That's where you're kind of happy that it's not a best of one, because like you've just lost once you load in. Anyway, GG's.